I'm Theresa.
Marina.
Justin,
nice to meet
you.
I'm Marina, this is my son Justin, and we're having Theresa over today for a private reading in hopes to connecting with my son Gregory.
So have you ever been to a medium before?
No, never. I feel nervous and excited at the same time. I like to hear that he had no pain and he's not suffering and that he's okay.
That's a great top.
Thank you.
Love that. Okay. So Spirit is guiding me in a way of having me give my speech differently to ease the nervousness about what's gonna take place. Because I feel like as much as you look so calm, cool, and collected, I feel like you're like this inside, right? Yeah. I actually heard something did you lose a child?
Yes.
And so you lost your oldest son?
Yes. Greg was just an amazing boy, funny and loved everyone. I miss him every single second of every minute of every hour of every day.
I don't know how to really like breathe without him, but I try my best because I have to. For Shane and Justin.
He's a big ham, your brother.
He's out of his mind.
Did he like Batman?
He did, a lot.
Was there something about a cape?
I was actually talking about that yesterday.
Yeah, he did.
Shut up. No, you weren't. I feel like he was running around the house in his underwear with a cape
That's
on.
That's what he does.
No, he didn't.
Yeah.
When me and Shane were younger, we used to wear like Superman, Batman costumes, and Greg used to run around the house with his fist like that. He wasn't a typical like older brother that he would pick on me and Shane. He was just extremely funny, caring, helped me out with basically anything. I can't really explain how much I miss him.
How do you connect with the month of August?
That's when he passed away.
Well, why do I feel like he was protecting?
He was in the Marines.
My son Gregory was a Marine and he joins because he wanted to serve his country. He volunteered to go to Afghanistan to train the Afghani police how to protect their own country.
He goes, Theresa, he goes, you're never gonna believe if I tell you what happened surrounding the passing. Because there's a part of me that I don't know who to believe or what to believe.
There's a lot of different stories.
Yes.
Why do I feel like there was like a blow to my chest? I actually kind of felt like an explosion type of thing.
Yeah.
I don't, your son was murdered? Like a cold-blooded killer. Like that's how I felt. I don't know if they shot him point blank.
It was.
My son was executed by an Afghani police that he was training. He was working out in a gym, and an Afghani police came in and shot rounds at all the Marines that were working out that morning.
He says, I need you to know that I wasn't afraid. And more importantly, that he did not suffer. When you keep saying why? Did you say that?
A lot. Why?
He says it was just something that was just so senseless.
It was senseless.
You're in a base, and the Afghani police are allowed to walk around on this base with machine guns while my son is sitting on a bench press with nothing to protect himself. So we need to know why this happened, and the answers aren't there.
Do you have all of his uniforms?
Yes.
Did you have them laid out on the bed?
Yes, I did.
So please know that when you did that, your son's soul was with you.
I just laid them out on my bed,
and I was just like, you know, breathing his scent. I just had to do that. I had to lay everything on my bed and get to hug him again.
Do you have a question about his passing?
I want to know if he's still around. Does he hear me when I speak to him?
With everything that you do, your son's soul is still with you. Do you have his dog tags?
Yes.
Were you waiting for him to talk about that?
Yes.
Because he goes, Theresa,
because I was hiding it.
If you don't talk about the dog tags, my mother's never gonna believe that it's me.
I was like, wow, she knew I had these on. I couldn't believe it.
I want to thank you for giving me the privilege of channeling your son.
I feel great. I feel like she did an excellent job in connecting with my son. It really made me feel like my son was definitely here and still is here.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Theresa just validated it for me, giving me exact details of my brother Greg.
Yep. Bye-bye. Thank you.
It made me feel better that he is okay and he's at peace and his soul is with me always.
Something really disturbing happened today after my private reading. I received a phone call from my son, Larry, telling me that our dog, Louie, had gotten out and is lost. Did anybody call?
Mm-mm.
I come home and there's Larry, my son, Larry, and my assistant, Courtney, and there is still no hide a hair of Louie. Can I watch it on the video camera? I want to see what happened.
With construction crews coming in and out of the house constantly, it's hard to keep tabs on Petey and Louie. It's no wonder they got out.
There's Louie.
There he goes.
Yep, there
he
goes.
Yeah, and he was running. Look at him.
Takes off, and Petey's here. Louie's by this car.
Oh, yeah, I see him by the car, yeah.
And he's right here right now. Then we lose him.
Louie, our little explorer, I think he thinks he's like Christopher Columbus or something. I don't really think he intentionally ran away. I think he just got caught up in his sniffing.
I made more flyers.
It is now day 3, 72 hours of Louie missing. I mean, aren't you worried about him? I'm starting to lose a little hope. Louie might not be coming home.
Hello?
Courtney?
Yes.
Hey, what's going on?
I got a voicemail about Louie.
My assistant Courtney just got a phone call from someone responding to our online post.
Where's the number?
It's right here.
And I just want to call this person right away.
Hello?
Hi, my name is Theresa. Do you have Louie or the Yorkie?
Yeah, no, I was over in Hicksville and it was late at night and I seen this little thing running around Jerusalem Avenue.
Oh, my God.
It almost got hit twice.
Oh, my God. So do you have him now?
Yeah, I have him. Someone should be at my house around 3 o'clock. You know, you could probably come by then and grab him.
That's great. Thank you. We finally got our first lead. It really sounds promising.
Can you believe we're getting Louie back?
You hit me, fool.
We don't have him yet. He's not here. We have to, you know, accept the reality if it's some other dog. I was still skeptical because I'm not gonna believe that anyone has my dog until he's back in my arms.
Let's go, Petey!
This might just really be too good to be true.
Here comes Mommy!
What if we get there and it's not even Louie? It's just an imposter.
Anyone could say that they have your dog. I need proof. I need to see it.
Okay, this is it. Let's see if Louie's here.
When we arrive at the house, I am a wreck.
You smell Louie?
Because what if it isn't Louie? What are we gonna do?
Well, he should be expecting us.
Hey,
hi.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Oh, it's Louie.
Is that Louie? Louie.
Louie.
Louie. Louie. Louie. Hi. Louie, it's you.
When I saw that furry little face and that confused look, I knew that was our Louie.
Look who it is. It's your brother.
Oh, my God. It was such a relief.
Louie. Is he kidding me?